1. When I open a file, I get a message, this is not an InPage document. How to fix? Answer: probably you are actually opening a document file of some other application. In case you are sure that you are opening an InPage document, then it's quite possible that on your last save the file was not saved properly. At this juncture, you have the option to open the back file and retrieve your document before the last save state. If you get the above message from opening the back file as well, then you can try retrieving only the text portion of your document without any formatting by importing the saved file as a text file in a new document. When you use the import text menu item and you get a import text dialog box, you should choose the file type as text file *.txt. This will lead to insertion of some junk characters at the beginning of the document, and after 8 to 9 pages you will start getting Urdu, Arabic, English text. You can remove the junk characters from your document and make fresh changes to this newly retrieved document. Question 2. I am changing font but the font is not getting applied. How to fix? Answer. This is because you have not selected the text to which you are applying the font. For all the character attributes like font change, font size, bold, italic, inter-character gap, baseline shift etc, you will always need to select the text to which you are applying these attributes. Question 3. I am intermixing English with Urdu, but why the English text appears bigger than Urdu text? Answer. A 12pt English text is bigger than a 12pt Urdu text. We have an option in the typographic preferences where you can set the reduce Latin font size field. By default, this is set to 18%. That at the same point size, English text will be reduced by 18%. You can modify this value to suit your needs. Question 4. Can I use mathematical equations in InPage? Answer. You can use InPage to intermix mathematical equations with Urdu, English text. These equations will need to be entered in MS Windows compatible software which supports equation. One such package is Microsoft's Equation Editor. Question 5. How to use object rotation in InPage? Answer. All the objects in an InPage document can be rotated. The rotation is carried out in object selection mode, i.e. with the arrow key. Once the object has been selected, it can be rotated by specifying the angle of rotation in the object dialog or by selecting the rotation tool and rotating the object. Question 6. How to text run around objects in InPage? Answer. When objects are placed on top of text box containing text, then you can control text run around these objects. By default, text boxes and picture boxes have the runaround option on. That is, these objects when placed on top of text box with text will lead to text getting repelled from these objects unless you choose runaround menu option from the format dialog and uncheck the runaround checkbox. Whereas for graphic boxes and lines, runaround option is off. Besides these default values, you can specify the distance that text will flow away from the object. Question 7. How to duplicate objects in InPage? Answer. Duplicate enables you to duplicate a group of selected objects in a tabular format. The duplicate dialog asks you information as to number of rows and number of columns in which the duplicated objects will be arranged. You will also be asked to specify column and row gap so as to offset each row of objects by this gap and each column by the column gap. Note that duplicate treats the selected objects as a group, and while duplicating calculates the outer bounding rectangle of this group of objects. Question 8. How to cut, copy, clear and paste of objects in InPage? Answer. Objects can be copied to clipboard or pasted from clipboard. Cut and clear both delete the selected object, whereas cut copies the objects to the clipboard. Clear just deletes the selected object. Copy, on the other hand, copies the selected objects to the clipboard without deleting the objects. Once the objects have been copied to clipboard, they can be pasted by invoking the paste command. On invoking the paste command, the cursor changes to paste cursor. You can click with this cursor anywhere on the page. All the objects on the clipboard are pasted with respect to this clicked reference point. If your document type is left to right, then this point is treated as left top of the boundary rectangle outlining all the selected objects. On the other hand, if your document type is right to left, then this point is treated as right top of the boundary rectangle. Question 9. How to marking an object as template object in InPage? Answer. Once an object is marked as template, then that object behaves as a master mold. You can make exact replicas of the template object by just dragging the template object. Instead of moving the template object, the dragging operation peels off an identical copy of the template object. You would usually make a template object in the pasteboard. Question 10. How to marking an object as don't print in InPage? Answer. Sometimes there is a need to mark one or more object as don't print so as to prevent the object or objects from being printed out. You can do so by checking the don't print checkbox in the format object dialog. To reset this attribute, you must uncheck this checkbox. Question 11. How to lock an object in InPage? Answer. You can lock an object so as to prevent its accidental movement or deletion. For locking, you have to invoke the appropriate object dialog by double-clicking on the object or objects and setting the lock checkboxes on. Once you lock an object, its selection points appear as gray rather than black, which is the case in normal selection. Once locked, you will not be able to move or delete the object. If you do need to carry out any one of these operations, then unlock the object. To unlock a locked object, you just have to uncheck the lock checkbox in the format object dialog box. A locked object has selection points, handles, that are gray in color, whereas unlocked objects have black handles. Question 12. How to use resizing object in InPage? Answer. A selected object has handles using which the object can be resized. Bring the mouse cursor on top of one of these handles. The cursor shape changes to a resize arrow. With this resize cursor, press the mouse and drag while keeping the mouse pressed. Leave the mouse when the required size has been achieved. Question 13. How to use moving object in InPage? Answer. To move an object, you will first select the arrow tool. Now click the mouse on top of the object. The object will get selected, and while keeping the mouse pressed, drag the mouse. The object will now move along with the mouse. On leaving the mouse, the new positions of the object gets registered and the changed values are reflected in the ribbon. Question 14. How to use selection object in InPage? Answer. For resizing, copying, deleting and changing attributes, you need to select an object. You can select an object with an arrow cursor. For this, first select the arrow tool. If you now click on the object, it will be selected and you will see highlighted selection points on the object. To select more than one object at the same time, keep the shift key pressed while other objects are selected with the help of the mouse. Question 15. How to use creation object in InPage? Answer. To create an object, you will first have to select the proper tool. All the creation tools display the cursor as cross. Now click the mouse in the document area and while keeping the mouse pressed, drag the mouse. The ribbon will show the X and Y coordinates where the mouse was clicked, as well as the updated width and height of the object as mouse is moved. When the required size of the box has been achieved, leave the mouse button. You will now get a selected object with size attributes as indicated in the ribbon. You can also create an object by entering its coordinates and its width and height in the object ribbon.